Itu nama kamu kebun.
Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and very good morning to everyone. So Puan and our lecturer Dr. Mahfuza. Okay, today we are from group 6. We are going to present on overhead water tank level indicator. So I'm Nur Azira Rosli. I'm number 1912 and this is Samiha. 1925-46 and this is Rosalie. 1936-18. So, next slide. So, guys, why do we need a water level indicator? Well, it is to overcome overflow problems and then to prevent wastage of water, to prevent wastage of energy. And it can also for attention and observation of the water level and for sustainable use of water and judicious use of electricity. So, this water level employs a simple mechanism to detect and indicate the water level in an overhead tank or any other water container. The sensing is done by using a set of 5 props which are placed at actually, it's 4 different levels where another one prop is at the same level as the first prop, which is at the base tank. So, the level 4, which is the prop 4, it represents when the tank is full or when the water is overflows. And then, while level 1 and the another prop, level 1 is to detect when tank is in empty condition.
Okay, so this is our simulation. Actually, in simulation we use switch because we doesn't have water in simulation. The simulation works like this. When this first wizard water, the switch is open switch. So it will, the LED will not light up. And after we put in water, so when the first wire touch the water, that's mean this wire, and that's mean the switch will close, and the LED here will light up. Okay, the same goes to the others. The level here, this is the bottom one, the second, third, and the last one with it's the but when the switch on the last one touch close, so the buzzer will so we can hear the sound of the buzzer. So this is our
I'm going to talk about the details of components. The first component I'm going to talk about is transistor 2 and 2. So this transistor is used for general purpose, low power amplifying or switching applications. In the second, we use NPN resistor to control input flows into the gas and the output is tied into the connector and to the emitter step at a fixed voltage. We cannot simply the NPN transistor as a factor of power and of frequency response, need to take as consideration. And also PNP gives for positive voltage from the emitter terminal and current flows from emitter to collector and then to test while NPN gives positive voltage to collector terminal and current flows from the collector to emitter. As the current increases to the test of NPN transistor, the transistor is turned on more until it conducts from collector to emitter. Next is resistor 230 ohm. This resistor is used to control the flow of current to other components. If we don't control the current flow, it might cause damage to the other components, such as LED. As you all know, LED needs a low voltage to function. So we use this resistor to limit the current flow so that we can use the other components. So the higher the value of resistor, when the resistance increase, when the resistance is increased, then the current flow through the circuit will decrease. It will cause the LED or I components to LED to light. The third one is buzzer. So our buzzer voltage range is 3 voltage to 24 voltage. The buzzer is used to produce a sound wave as a signaling component. It will ring when the water is full in the tank. So yes, each buzzer has their own range of voltage. Our buzzer is from 3 to 24 voltage. So when our voltage source is higher than the range, our buzzer will damage. And if our voltage source is lower than the range, our buzzer will start not produce any sound. The fourth one is light emitting diode. This is diode, LED. So LED is basically to emit visible light when an electric current passes through. And it requires a limited current so that this LED can function good. So we use resistor again to make it function. So this is our power voltage. We use 9 voltage because if we use lower than this, our LED will light dim. Okay. So this is breadboard, and breadboard basically is a construction base for prototyping of electronics. It is used for temporary prototyping and experimenting with circuit type.
This is actually the simulation how it works. Okay, just like I said, when we put water in the beaker, so the first wire which is at the lowest height will turn the first LED to light up. So that means we know that it's very low water in the tank. And when the wire 2 touch, when we keep pour the water, so when the water touch the wire 2, so the second LED we light up, that means the level is this will be and so on. And then and after the touch the last wire, so the buzzer will produce the sound and we can hear the sound after we this.
So thus this simple circuit depicts how a simple water level inverter helps us in preventing the flow of water and further help in reducing the wastage of water and power. So it turns us to be a very useful appliances which can be used. So now we are going to see the simulation of our
so this is our prototype of the water level indicator. As we pour the water, the light will turn off.
Yes. So this is for the prop number one. So the first LED will light up. So when it reaches the second prop, the second LED will light up. And then for the when it reaches 3/4 of the water tank, the second LED will light up. And then when it reaches full, the buzzer will make a sound.
So as you say, the electricity pass through the water. Will people get electrocuted when they connect with the water?
The water is connected, right? It acts as a circuit, right? So if people touch contact with the water, will they be electrocuted? That's my question. No, that's my question.
It depends on the voltage. It depends on the voltage. Since we use low voltage, then it doesn't affect your inhalation.
Okay.
The range, the volt range, right? 3 until 24 volt. So if we use the word in between the range, so I think it's fine to use the this circuit, or maybe we can change the value of resistor slightly. When we use the we have to change the value of the resistor if we use higher voltage. So we can maintain the LED limit.
Yes, and if we use the voltage lesser than what